Well, there is three hadith actually that we can talk about regarding this matter.
Sorry, yeah. Just before you say that, is there a hadith that says if you catch the jama'ah in ruku, you've made the rakat?
No, there's no such hadith sahih that says that.
Okay, because if it was sahih, I was going to ask. I thought Fatiha.
You have to read the Fatiha.
So, if they're in ruku.
If they are in ruku,
you've missed it.
Then you read the Fatiha. You start reading the Fatiha. If the Imam does ruku quickly, then you don't know that he is going to do ruku quick, no? Because the Prophet said the Imam does ruku before you, and he comes before you. He said, Oswald, whoever, no matter how much I do ruku before you, you will catch me when coming back. So by the time he starts saying Allahu Akbar coming back, you can't do ruku'ah. You understand?
So you must do the Fatiha.
You read the Fatiha, and then when, if you finished, if he has done ruku'ah quick, long, you have finished Fatiha, you go ruku'ah. If by the time is you see that you are not going to finish it and he is coming back from ruku'ah, you go to ruku'ah with him. And then you disregard that rak'ah.
Disregard it?
You disregard that rak'ah where you didn't read al-Fatiha. You didn't finish al-Fatiha.
Okay.
Let's say you are reading, then you see him coming back. Okay. Khair,
yeah.
Inshallah. Anyway, so the next thing is that here it says about prostrating. What was it about? Prostrating on seven limbs. Prostrating on seven limbs. Well, there is three hadith that can be mentioned in this topic. The hadith of Ibn Abbas is a famous hadith. I have been ordered to prostrate on seven limbs. But hadith of Ibn Abbas, of course, someone might say, this is special for the Prophet. He says, I have been ordered to. Okay, the fact that he said I have been ordered, that means that is what he has been doing. Yeah? To prostrate on seven limbs. And then he said, pray the way you see me praying. The hadith, there is a narration that says, Umirna. We have been ordered, not I have been ordered, but that is shad anyway. There is the hadith of Ibn Umar that says, narrated by Ahmed ibn Hanbal, where he says that that the hands prostrate the way the face prostrate. So when someone put his face, he should put his hands on the floor. That is regarding the face and the hand. Doesn't really give the details like about seven. But this hadith is considered to be, well, there is different opinions whether it is mawquf or marfu', whether it's the saying of Ibn Umar, or because Ayyub narrated it from Nafi', from Ibn Umar, Wuhayb ibn Khalid and Ismail ibn Ulayya narrated it from Ayyub, Nafi' ibn Umar, from the Prophet. However, Hamad ibn Zayd made it the saying of Ibn Umar. There is a hadith in Muslim from Al-Abbas ibn Abdul Muttalib where he says that إذا سجد العبد when العبد Muslim, slave of Allah, does sujood, he seven parts do sujood with him, exactly like the hadith of Al-Abbas, Abdullah ibn Abbas. So that hadith clearly, even though it is a khabar here, it is considered to be an order.
Yeah,
it can't be
transferred.
So that is in replacing the hadith of Ibn Abbas. and that's general for everybody. Yeah, this is the hadiths that can that are sahih or are to be considered to be sahih in this regarding this matter. And it make it an obligation for the person to sujood on seven bonds. Finished.